do now my short speech of welcoming you. We have changed slightly the order because the agenda of our minister need to leave. I would like to say a special word to Mrs. Paula Abreu Marques, representing our Director-General for Energy from the European Commission, and to Mr. João Paulo Oliveira from the Navigator Company, representing here the private sector. And it's, as I've told you, it's really an honor to be the chair of such a fantastic conference that brings experts, brings together experts from all over the world to discuss the role of biomass in fighting climate change. We will discuss scientific advancements, the new technological developments, industrial applications, and this year also we have introduced the topic that is very important in general, but special to biomass, biofuels, and bioenergy, that is the science-based policy making for public policies. And we have on Thursday, one parallel event dedicated to this topic of the science-based policy making. So the European Biomass Conference is the world-leading event and the biggest conference in the area of biomass. And biomass is part of our low-carbon future. The use of biomass to produce power, heat, transportation fuels, and materials is one of the most promising options to combat climate change. For example, still today, biomass is part of the only feasible scenario for delivering carbon neutral solutions, for example, for aviation or shipping or heavy road transport. And biomass is part of this fantastic transformation that the European Commission and the European institutions are leading, that is combating climate change and building an energy union that ensures that energy is safe, viable, and accessible for all. This is exactly one of the 10 priorities of the present Commission, and I'm sure will be at the top priorities of the next European Commission. Actually, new rules on renewables, energy efficiency, and governance of the energy union have been recently agreed by the European Parliament and the European Council, and Paula Abreu Marques was very much at the center of this discussion. This package will help Europe to sustain its world leadership in the energy transition. But we will reach affordable, clean energy for all, not changing drastically our way of life, only with a strong involvement and investment in research, science, innovation, and technology. That will be the key to close the triangle of environment, economy, and sustainability. This is why our European Research and Innovation Programme Horizon 2020 has devoted 60% of its 77 billion euros to sustainable development, and that climate-related expenditure should attain the value of 35% of the overall budget. And that's why the European Commission has proposed for the new program Horizon Europe for 7 years starting in 21, has proposed a budget of 100 billion and environment, sustainable development, and climate change will be one of the top priorities. And this conference is a meeting place to discuss all these topics, and is at the right moment when we are at the finalizing the European Conference on Biomass is about promoting research and innovation in biomass and bioenergy from frontier research to industrial applications. It's also about research and innovation, but is also about science and scientific evidence in policy making in the field of biomass and bioenergy. And as I told you, the present edition pays a special attention, and we will discuss, for example, the role of biomass in carbon capture and utilization and how science advice plays a role on this. This conference will have 4 days, 4 full days, and the 5th day devoted to field visits to see industrial applications and utilization of technologies and policies in Portugal. The conference constitutes a comprehensive source of the state-of-the-art information and very important for research technologists, decision makers, industrialists that are involved on the biomass sector. And we are gathering about 1,400 delegates from 75 countries from 5 different continents. We have a strong participation of Europeans, about 80%, but not only Europeans. The second continent is Asia. We have a strong participation of Asia, but also North and South America and Africa. The highest number of registers are from Portugal, 189. The second is German, but we have strong delegations, and I welcome from quite far away, South Korea, Japan, and Brazil. We will have very interesting parallel sessions and also hosted events, and I will draw your attention, for example, for this afternoon, an event for the status of the bioenergy in Portugal. We have also 1 day of explaining what is our bio-based program joint undertaking at the European Commission and the bio-based products and the circular economy. That will be a very interesting event. We have the EU-Japan Biomass Seminar. We have a workshop where we present results from our Horizon 2020 projects on the biomass. So you see, we will have very interesting sessions and workshops for you to attend. For all these reasons, I'm very happy to welcome you to this conference and to Lisbon. And I hope that you have still time to visit our city, and you will realize, the ones that still do not know Lisbon very well, that Lisbon is a very beautiful city, but is also a city of science, a city of innovation, a city of culture. Lisbon is very cosmopolitan, and it is a city open to the world. And this is also one of the reasons that is important to have this conference here, because we defend a science and innovation that is open to the world, a conference that is open to the world, that is a meeting point from different people from all over the world, and what better place to do that than in Lisbon. Also, as our minister has also stressed, one important reason that Portugal and Lisbon is a good place to have this conference is that Portugal is a pioneer country in renewable energy, and we have a very high ambitions also for the future in the area of renewable energy and fighting climate change. So for all that reasons, the organization, and I thank Angela and all the organizers for having chosen Portugal and Lisbon to held the 27th edition of the conference climate change. So I hope that you enjoy the conference, that you work hard, but you also have some spare time to go to just walk around Lisbon.